Hello and welcome to this video tutorial brought to you by tastetudes.com. In the previous episode, we looked at how to draw in Illustrator using the pen, pencil and brush tool. In this video, we are going to be taking a look at the Blob brush tool and the eraser tool. Now, the Blob brush tool allows us to draw similar to the brush tool by drawing freehand strokes, though unlike the brush tool, the Blob tool does not work along a vector path. The Blob tool essentially creates and builds vector shapes. The Eraser tool works to remove parts of a vector shape. To follow along with this tutorial and practice these tools, you will need to open this document I have prepared especially for this tutorial. This can be found in the Essential Practice folder, in the Project folder. You can download this project folder for free. The download link is in the description. Along the way, I will be mentioning some useful shortcut keys, which you can find in the description and in the shortcut key page in the project PDF, which you can also download in the description. So, with the project folder open, click Essential Practice, Blob Brush, Versions, and select the version of Illustrator you're using. In my case, it's CC, and open the Blob Brush file, and you should have something that looks like this. Now, we're going to be covering a lot in this video, and in quite some depth. If you wish to skip ahead at any point in the video or back, you can do so quite simply. The topics covered in this video are listed in the description, along with their times, so be sure to check that out. So once you have this document open, let's get into it. So once you have your document open, we are going to begin by selecting the Blob Brush tool from the menu. This tool can be found under the Pencil tool, or you can use the shortcut Shift-B on the keyboard. With the Blob Brush tool active, you will now see the mouse cursor change to what appears to be a brush and a circle. The circle represents your stroke size. Now, we can toggle the size of this stroke by using the keyboard shortcuts. Now, I'm simply going to draw a scribble on the canvas like so, and upon release, we have our scribble. Now, if I press V to activate the selection tool and click on the scribble, we notice immediately that this is now a vector shape, as we can see a vector outline and the anchor points that create the vector. Unlike the pen, pencil and brush tool that creates strokes along a vector path, the Blob tool creates vector shapes. Next, I'm going to press Shift-B to activate my Blob brush tool again, but this time I'm going to draw a line through the middle of my scribble. Then I'm going to press V to activate the selection tool and again select the scribble. Notice this time how the line I just created on top of the scribble has been merged into the first initial composition. So we can use the Blob tool to build vector shapes and continue to draw on top to add to them. With this vector shape, we can treat it as such as adding stroke and color fill effects. So again, I'm going to press Shift-B to activate my Blob Brush tool, but before I begin, I'm going to click the default color fill and stroke to reset my colors. I'm going to draw a scribble like so, then I'm going to select a new color from my swatches panel, making sure it's not the same black color. Let's go for an orange, and I need to make sure my stroke color is now orange in the tools menu, and I'm going to draw another scribble on top like so. Then I'm going to choose another color from the swatches and draw another scribble and another until I have something that looks like this. This time, if I press V to activate the selection tool and click on the color vectors, we can now see that they are in fact individual objects. So earlier we learned that the Blob Brush tool can draw and merge vector shapes, but it's only by color. If you use the Blob Brush tool to draw and use the same color to draw on top, only then will it merge together. If you use different colors, they don't merge. It's as if the colors distinguish them as individual elements. So keep that in mind. Next, we are going to take a look at the Eraser tool. Now, the Eraser tool can be found in the menu under the Blob Brush tool, or you can use the shortcut Shift E. With the Eraser tool active, you will see the cursor change to a circle, indicating the area which you will remove, and we can toggle the size of this easily using the keyboard shortcuts. Now, the Eraser tool can be used to delete parts of a vector shape or smooth a surface of a vector outline. The eraser tool can be very useful along with the blob brush tool. So I have two vector shapes here, a stroke and a solid fill. With the selection tool, I'm going to select the first vector. Then I'm going to press Shift E to activate the eraser tool. I'm going to push up my eraser area like so, place my eraser tool over the vector outline and simply click once. Now you can see that the area has been removed from my vector shape and the vector outline of my shape has been redefined. Notice, if I try and click on any other vector shape, nothing works. If you select a particular vector shape, the eraser tool will only be applied to your selection. If I press V and select the next vector, press Shift E, toggle my brush size, I can remove parts of the next example like so. Easy. Now, the eraser tool can be very useful along with the blob brush tool. Let's have a look at the next examples. Here, I have a blob shape and a rose illustration from the previous video. For this example, I'm going to attempt to color in this blob shape and the rose using the blob brush tool, then use the eraser tool to redefine. If we look in the layers panel over here on the right, if you cannot see your layers panel, then you can come up and click on window and select it from there. We can see this document consists of three layers. The top layer, the strokes on top layer, and if I toggle the visibility of this layer, we can see the strokes that make up these examples sit on this layer. This layer is also locked, so we don't accidentally edit or move our examples. The layer beneath this is the Add Color layer, and this is the layer we are going to use the Blob Brush tool on. Now, I have prepared the layers in this way as to keep the black strokes on top of our color, which we are about to add. So by pressing I on the keyboard, I'm going to use the Eyedropper tool to select the green from my sample here. Press Shift B to activate the Blob Brush tool and begin to draw where I would like to place color like so. Upon release, we will now have the blob of color, but now we can see some color outside the outline. So I'm going to make sure the vector shape is selected, press Shift E and carefully remove the parts I don't want, like so, until I have something that looks like this. So on the next example, I'm going to use a combination of the blob brush tool and the eraser tool to add some color and highlights, selecting some pre-chosen colors on the right. And hopefully that should demonstrate how easy it can be to create unique vector shapes and add color and effects to your artwork. So that's an introduction to the blob brush tool and the eraser tool. In the next video, we will be taking a look at text in Adobe Illustrator and some of the tools and effects that can be used. See you in the next video.